The years before World War I saw a wave of bitter strikes across Britain. Ireland, which was part of the United Kingdom at that time, was the scene of violent unrest and protests, both over working conditions and against British rule. In Dublin, the capital city, many people lived in slum conditions and suffered appalling poverty and high infant mortality. 75% of workers were unskilled with low wages.
In 1909, a militant trade union for unskilled workers in Ireland was set up by James Larkin. They had early successes and membership grew quickly. The employers decided to fight back, led by business owner William Martin Murphy. He made his workers choose between the union or a job and sacked hundreds of people who he thought were sympathetic to Larkin. Other employers followed suit and workers had to pledge to have nothing to do with the union or be locked out.
The dispute soon involved 20,000 employees across the city. Clashes between workers and the police were frequent and violent. The TUC tried to negotiate a settlement, but the employers refused. It seemed they planned to starve the workers into submission, so the TUC set up the Dublin Food Fund to help the strikers, and they turned to the CWS for help. No other organisation in the country had the food stocks needed.
But it was not just the capacity of the CWS, it was the solidarity that was vital. And the TUC saw the CWS as another part of the same movement of working men and women, the labour movement. The food stocks were low as the CWS had recently celebrated its 50th birthday and Jubilee packets had been distributed. But somehow the food was found.
Staff worked throughout the night to weigh and pack the food before sending it to the docks in Salford. Striking dockers turned out to help, putting aside their own needs to help the starving strikers in Dublin. The CWS chartered a ship, which set off in dense fog down the Manchester Ship Canal. It was a dangerous route to travel, but the captain knew that thousands of people were desperately waiting in Dublin. He decided the risk was worth taking, and slowly, the ship made her way to the clear waters of the Irish Sea.
Huge crowds waited for hours to greet the ship and sounded hooters across Dublin Bay when it arrived. The enemies of the Union said that it was impossible. But thanks to the CWS, help had arrived and the parcels were distributed to 30,000 people. Each family received 10 pounds of potatoes and a bag of food staples. It was an immense morale boost to the starving strikers and their families, and the ship's crew were presented with CWS medals on their return home. More food came through, but the strike began to crumble in January 1914 and workers returned to work. But the CWS had shown what could be done when the cooperative and trade union movements worked together.